Yeah, welcome back to the second half. Look, I want to take just a quick minute, make sure you know about Tulsa. You saw it during the break there. March 21st and 22nd, we'll be at the Marriott Southern Hills for a special type of Flashpoint Live. It's different than any of our other meetings. It's unique, and you want to be there. If you were wanting a VIP ticket, those are sold out. Sorry you missed that. But there are some other tickets left to be a part. Go to 2024flashpoint.live. We're looking forward to meeting every one of you that comes. That's why we're doing a smaller event, so we make sure that we meet every person that walks through the door to be a part of Flashpoint. We want to meet you. So looking forward to seeing you there, but go online right now. Get your ticket, 2024flashpoint.live, and we'll see you there. Now, programming note, tomorrow night, Flashpoint's just like normal at our normal time. Then we'll go right into America Stands tomorrow night and give you all the latest coverage on Super Tuesday and the vote of 8 p.m. Central. We'll go right into it. That's tomorrow night. Make sure you're right here watching history happen with us here at the Victory Channel. All right, well, over the last week in Texas, if you've been watching the news, or some of the news is reported, in the Texas Panhandle, raging wildfires have torched more than 1 million acres with 2 fatalities and hundreds of residents that were forced to evacuate their homes. Pastor Brian Gibson is the founding and senior pastor of his church with a campus there in Amarillo, Texas. He sent this video to Flashpoint this weekend, and we want to share it with you now. Watch.
Well, we've had one of the largest wildfires in Texas history. It's been like 1 million acres burnt. The church prayed last night corporately. We prayed for rain. We've been praying 3 hours a day this week. And I want you to see what we woke up to this morning. I hear the sound of an abundance of rain. Come on, your God will answer. Your God will answer. Your God will answer. Your God will answer. He answers by fire. Sometimes he answers by snow. He's good.
All right. Let me welcome to Flashpoint again, Pastor Brian Gibson. Brian, good to have you here, sir.
Hey, it's great to be here with you, Pastor Gene. What an honor.
So tell me about how all this happened and how you, let's talk about, first off, I don't want to let you go tonight without talking about what's been going on there with revival in your church. So let's make sure we hit that. But first off, let's talk about these fires and what you guys have been dealing with.
Yeah, you know, we're out in the panhandle of Texas, some of the driest country in the world. And kind of crazy chain of events this week, but, you know, over 1 million acres of burnt, some say as high as 1.7 million acres, largest wildfire in Texas history. So I'm in the altar, pastor, last Sunday, and I'm praying for people, and the Spirit of God spoke to me, and he said, Brian, I want you to pray 3 hours a day this week. I run a prayer meeting every day, 7 to 8, corporate prayer. God said specifically pray 3 hours. So after church last Sunday, I went to my wife and I said, I don't know what's coming. I don't know if World War III is going to break out, but it's like a warning in my spirit. Something's coming. So Tuesday afternoon, that fire hits our country over here, starts running, spreading rapidly. You got 60 mile an hour winds, which means the fire's jumping everywhere. And in Amarillo, Texas on Tuesday night, our houses were filled with smoke, and it's blowing ash into the city of almost 250,000 people. Now, it burned out some of the towns, Fritch, Texas. You know, it got into Pampa, got into Canadian, got into Stinnett, did damage, lost homes, and we had some loss of life. My house was just right in an evacuation zone on Tuesday night, Pastor. So we loaded up our kids. It's like, kids, get one thing you want, a change of clothes. We're going to get out of here just to be on the safe side. On Wednesday night, we started praying. Because when you see, if you haven't been around wildfires like this, you don't understand how apocalyptic it really is. Yeah. About 5 years ago, I got caught up close to one, and man, it's here. So we prayed, and God answered the next morning with 3.5 inches of snow that wasn't supposed to go to Amarillo and wasn't supposed to go up north. I'm talking a miracle, Pastor.
It was a miracle. But let me, in fact, I have a picture of your wife, Jessie. I love this shirt. Work hard, eat beef, and pray for rain. Now, those are my kind of people. These are my people right here. Eat beef, the real kind. But Pastor Gibson, talk to us about, I want to get, so many people, believers, watch this program every week. Tell them about revival that's been going on.
Yeah, in October, God showed up in a special way at our church. I'll tell you a couple of things happened to kick it off. One, this kid is out front, and I could tell he's a kid, he's 25, strung out front of my church house, and he's laying, holding onto the threshold of the church, pastor. My secretaries come and get me. They say, pastor, we don't know if this guy's dangerous. Can you come talk to him? So me and a buddy walk out. The kid's laying there, and I say, hey, son, can I help you? What's going on with you, man? Can I pray for you? And he looked up, and he said, my mother brought me here when I was a little boy. And he was across town smoking rock early in the morning. And he said, something told me if I walked back to this church, maybe, just maybe, I could find God. Wow. And we ministered to that guy, and it was supernatural. God's calling prodigals home. Also, at that same time, my wife got up on a Sunday morning, pastor, and prophesied. She stopped the worship service, and she said, I got a word from the Lord here. She said, I'm supposed to tell somebody, and it's not just the scripture, it's a prophetic word. I'm supposed to tell somebody, you'll live and not die, declare the works of the Lord. And I'm sitting there and I'm saying, well, you know, that's a nice scripture, but I wouldn't have shut the whole service down to say it, Jess. You know, and she's looking at me. She knows what I think. We talk telepathically. We've been married 24 years. 8 minutes later, a guy dropped dead in the balcony. And then that word means something. So how on a scale of one to dead, how dead was he? Looked pretty dead to me, right? You know, I'm not a walking right. Cleveland Clinic, but he looked dead. And the whole church started praying. They called paramedics. People start working. Your health people are working there. And I walk up into the balcony after 5 or 6 minutes of them working. And I say, hey, I agree with what was prophesied. I say you'll live and not die, declare the works of the Lord. I rebuke death. I command life into you. When I said it, his eyes popped open, his tongue went back out of his mouth, and he looked up and he said, I'm fine. And I'm telling you, it got everybody's attention. I had undivided attention that morning, pastor. So it set us on a trajectory. And then we had a set of meetings where people just wouldn't leave the church. So they're staying till midnight, healings breaking out. I'm talking cancers, deaf ears. Two guys have died in our church service since October, and both of them. The second one, people said he wasn't really dead on the first one. A second one died in a church service. I have hundreds of witnesses, cardiac nurses on their carotid looking at us saying, pastors, he's dead. You got to pray. Second time, we jumped up and down. We're screaming, live, live, live. I think when you jump, you get closer to heaven. Maybe God hears you better. I don't know. But the second guy, same thing happened. Life popped back into him. And he's sitting, we call it Lazarus. He comes to every service. He's sitting on the row. He's brought 20, 30 people every service with us. Listen, revival's not coming to America. Revival's not coming to America, pastor. Revival's not coming to America. Revival is here. Believe it, preach it, prophesy it. God's going to shake us.
Well, that's awesome. Although I don't know if saying come to his church and people die is necessarily the best marketing plan, but that's amazing. Pastor Sam, what do you think about what's happening there?
No, I love it. I agree with Pastor. Revival is already here, and praise be God and what he did with the snow. Supernatural intervention. And I'm the one out there, along with Pastor Brian and Pastor Hank and others, just issuing a clarion call. There is a move of God that we are currently experiencing like we've never seen before. We have to open up our eyes and acknowledge it, be cognizant of it. In California, for example, in our church, for the glory of Christ, since November, we have seen over 650 people receive Jesus for the first time as Lord and Savior. This is California now, close to San Francisco. We have more people than chairs. There's a revival happening. There's an awakening. There's spiritual hunger in America, arguably like we've never seen before. I believe what's happening in Texas, California, in Nebraska, and around America is just the beginning. The best is yet to come.
It is best to come. Pastor Hank, you hear this going on. I mean, what do you think? Things are happening there in Nebraska as well?
Well, I think of a lot of prophetic fulfillment on what's happening with that pastor. I like that pastor. That's the kind of church that you want. It's the kind of church we have here where God shows up. But you got to understand, God asked me a question one time. He said, what does a nation look like filled with glory? I said, Lord, I can't answer that question. I've never seen it. And he began to deal with me. He said, things begin to change. And one of the things that he said would mark change would be 1 Kings 18:41, where the prophet declared, I hear the sound of an abundance of rain. It broke a harsh season. The pastor just mentioned that. That was the scripture he prayed. It marks a change from this rough season. Second thing that happens when God's presence comes, miracle signs, wonders, heart change, people's lives begin to get in order. But watch this. The first half of the show, Pastor Gene, we talked about the lunacy that's coming from the left and even from these ridiculous rhinos. That's another thing that happens. When the glory begins to show up, people who are influenced by the demonic begin to act like loony. And that's what's happening with some of the ones we saw in the interviews. So this is all prophetic indicators. And I want to say this last thing. Pastor Gene, September 14th, at our conference that you were there, Flashpoint, it was Flashpoint Live. God said the snow would be a sign and there would be fires. He talked about how the weather would be hot one day, record setting in America, summer temperatures, and then the next day it would drop and be cold, winter temperatures, all to signify this is about God's season now, and the elements will prophesy, and they are, because change is in the air. God's change.
Yeah, good change. In fact, with that, Pastor Brian, you were in the 80s before you had snow and rain, isn't that right? Talk about that.
Yes. Yeah, it was 82 degrees the day before. I was playing golf and I was in short pants. And, you know, then the fire blows in, gets cold. Obviously, we're praying for rain. God sends snow. He one-ups us. But, yes, just like Prophet prophesied, the weather shifted rapidly. And it doesn't seem natural, just to be quite honest. It seems seems odd. It seems strange. So the patterns are weird. And these fires, it just something seems amiss for it. But I believe God's answering and helping us in the midst of that.
All right. So, Brian, before I let you mentioned something that we've talked about here. And I want to put the prayer line up here for people because I want you to pray. Because when you started talking about the revival going on in your church, you mentioned the prodigals coming home. There are people all over the world that watch this show every time we're airing. You need to pray for them. Please, sir, pray for them. Minister to them. Take the next couple minutes there and let the Lord lead you.
Yeah, listen, right now there's pastors and ministers watching. You're saying, I want that in my church. God says, I want to do that in your church. He says, draw nigh unto me, I'll draw nigh unto you. I'll pour out my spirit upon your congregation, upon your sons and your daughters, they'll prophesy. I declare all over America, the blind are going to see, the deaf are going to hear, people are going to receive their life back, dead are going to rise. Revival's coming. I see some of you right now with prodigals. You got prodigals at college campuses. God says, I'm going to grab college campuses around America, and I'm going to shake them with my presence and with my glory. What you saw in Florida State already just about a month ago is going to begin to sweep across this nation during this spring season. During the spring semester, God will start grabbing prodigals and bringing them home. In the fall, God will accelerate it. You'll watch it sweep through the nations. Watch what God does. It's going to blow your mind. Right now, God says he's coming for prodigals. He's going to sweep up lost sons. He's going to draw lost sheep. He's going to find lost coins. There's girls coming back off of fentanyl addiction. There's kids that are lost in New Age religion. Some of them don't know their identity. Right now, they're trending towards being a transsexual or something. God's going to redeem them. I'm going to pray now and agree with you, mom, dad, grandmother, they're coming home. Right now, we call every prodigal home in the name of Jesus. Prodigal, I command you to wake up now. Wake up from your slop. Yes. Arise from your bed. Arise from your slumber. Come up, child. Come to your senses. Come home, daughter. Come home, son. Come home to the Father's house. You're going to be refreshed. I join my faith with every mother, father, every praying grandmother, granddad right now. We call that kid born again, full of the Spirit of God. We say that they'll never give another day to the devil. In Jesus' mighty name.
Oh, wow. Amen. 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 We agree with that. There's a phone number right there on the screen. You can call 877-281-6297 if you'd like someone else to pray with you a little bit further. Maybe you have questions. There's a licensed prayer minister on the other end of that line. That's why we are here. It's a free call, but it's a life-changing phone call that you can make when you pick up the phone and call. We're going to leave it up for just a couple of minutes. Pastor Brian, thank you for coming by. Please update us. We want to come crash your revival and see what God's doing in your church.
Hey, we'd love to have you. What an honor, Pastor.
Thank you. Thank you for being here. All right. So, Rick, that's really, you know, I haven't gone to you in a minute or two here. You know, when we see this, the whole thing with kids coming home, this is the whole reason we are here. at Flashpoint. Yeah. You know, we're talking 1 minute about politics and 1 minute about your kids coming home and revival and rain, supernatural. That's what it's all about, isn't it?
Man, it's the American way. That's why history is his story. It's not just America. It's all throughout God's history. Done this very thing. I was thinking that as Pastor Brian was telling the story, and it's like, wait a minute, this is exactly what the founding fathers went through in the founding era. So if anybody's watching this and going, oh, I don't believe that stuff, or I don't believe God moves in that way, or changes the weather based on prayers, listen, Ben Franklin was one of the least religious founding fathers, and he stands up at the Constitutional Convention and he reminds the other founding fathers, remember what it was like in the beginning of our contest with Great Britain. We had daily prayers. That's why I was so interested in Pastor Brian saying that, where he was called to daily prayer at the church. Ben Franklin said the same thing. He said, we had daily prayer. Our prayers were heard and they were graciously answered. All of us engaged in the struggle saw superintending providences. They saw God move with the weather. George Washington talked about it. The wind came in at the right time, or the rain, or the storm, right, or whatever it was. God moved through those storms for his will among his people. It's been so that good. Way, not just since the beginning of this country, but certainly since the beginning of time. But in America, we have recognized that. And we've had daily prayer called on by our presidents and our governors and our legislatures, moving back to that, where we acknowledge God and we call on him and we ask for exactly what Pastor Brian was talking about. That's what will restore our nation. Absolutely essential that we do that. It's not new in our history. It goes all the way back to the beginning of this nation.
Amen. You know what, Pastor Sam, I'm going to ask you to do something, and I'm going to ask you to pray right now in Spanish. For those as well, all of our Latino audience that are for some reason watching tonight, don't really understand bits and pieces, pray for them as well right now, for their prodigals coming home.
In the name of Jesus, Padre, en este momento preciso, por la voluntad de tu Espíritu Santo, desatamos esta palabra sobre cada familia. Que todos vuestros hijos pródigos regresen a casa en esta temporada. Declaramos que vuestras familias serán salvas. Hechos 16:31, tu promesa es para cada una de vuestras familias. Este es el año que todos los hijos pródigos van a regresar a casa. Así lo declaramos por fe. Este es el año de grande lluvia, lluvia celestial, lluvia santa sobre cada casa, cada familia, cada lugar, en el nombre de Jesucristo.
Amen. Amen. We agree with that. Amen. I'm telling you, there's something special tonight. Call the number. I see on social media people putting the names of their prodigals. That's a great, great idea. We've done that before. Feel free. Put it out there as your step of faith that you want to see your prodigals come home if you feel so led to do so. All right, while you're calling and while you're doing that on social media, I want to get to this one last segment because it's so very important to America, and it's what is happening at the border. Look at this clip with from 60 Minutes with Raul Ortiz. He's a former border chief. Watch.
You don't just plant a flag just to plant a flag. It's got to be strategic and it's got to make sense.
Raul Ortiz served as chief of the U.S. Border Patrol under President Biden and deputy chief under President Trump. He retired last year.
When agencies are making a decision based upon politics or whether they're going to get media coverage, hey, we're going to put all our personnel in this 2-mile stretch. What about the other 200 miles?
In our interview, Ortiz criticized Governor Abbott for not cooperating with the Border Patrol and playing politics with immigration. But he also expressed frustration with President Biden.
I've never had one conversation with the president or the vice president for that matter. And so I was the chief of the Border Patrol. I commanded 21,000 people. That's a problem.
I just saw 50 people today who had just crossed the border illegally. So something's not working.
We need to make sure that Central America, South America, Mexico, that those regions understand that if you pay a smuggler and you cross in between the ports of entry and you do not have a legitimate claim to some sort of asylum benefit, you're gonna be sent back.
Do you believe that the White House has sent mixed messages to migrants?
Yeah, most definitely.
Most definitely indeed. All right, Pastor Sam, first off, it's amazing to me that the president or vice president, no one ever reached out to him during his tenure there. But I want you to speak to, because your organization, the NHCLC, came out with a statement this week. Explain about what that is and your stand on immigration.
In full disclosure, we had the privilege of working with the Bush administration on this issue. We worked with Obama for 8 years, and then we worked with President Donald Trump. Over dinner with President Trump, I gave him a proposal embedded in what we just recently released. And the White House under Trump engaged yours truly to negotiate back then with Nancy Pelosi, something that Chuck Schumer did away with. There was a compromise. There was a deal on the table. And Chuck Schumer said no, he would not give President Trump a victory. It's real simple. We secure the border immediately. We finished building the wall. Concrete wall, satellite, infrared imaging. We utilize all of our technology and resources. We can stop every single illegal entry today if we have the wherewithal and the fortitude to actually accomplish it. Number two, we stop with catch and release. Stop that. Never again. If you come into this country and we catch you, we deport you. You'll never be able to come back into this country ever again, not even for a one-day Disneyland tour. You're done. So we stop catch and release. Number three, we go back to the stay in Mexico law. You're staying in Mexico. You're applying for asylum. You can't apply for asylum while coming in here illegally. You apply for asylum, and the maxim is you'll stay in Mexico until you are processed accordingly. We do all of that, and we do away with the issue of amnesty. No amnesty. No, citizenship is only for those who are born in America and for those who are naturalized legally without ever entering our country illegally. There it is. If we convey this message, we stop illegal immigration today. It is morally reprehensible. It is wrong to exploit individuals who are desperate, the vast majority, for a better day for the purpose of political gain. And that's what's happening right now. 8 million illegal entries, unacceptable. It is the continuum of lawlessness, and it must stop.
It must stop. All right, real quick, wrap it up here. Rick, you got 30 seconds.
Man, all I got to say is Sam for Border Czar. I'm telling you, he just articulated exactly the formula.
Right.
And I pray that in the Trump administration, Sam, you're given the opportunity to minister at the border, but also minister justice at the border. I think God's calling you for that, brother. Something like that. Maybe you're going to be Secretary of Homeland Security. I don't know. Whatever it is, God's going to use you to lead the way to secure our border once again.
All right, Pastor Hank, 20 seconds.
In my best Spanish, Espíritu Santo, Gloria a Dios.
There you have it. Spoken like a true Latino. Not really. All right. So thank you so much for watching. Remember, tomorrow night, America stands immediately following Flashpoint. So join us at our regular time. Stay with us until the end of the evening as we bring you all the latest on all of the election delegates that he needs tomorrow night. Trump can't get there tomorrow, but he'll get real close if he wins them all. Thank you for joining us here on Flashpoint. Remember, Victory Channel is here for you. Take advantage of all the programmers here and all the programs. Thank you for being with us. Remember, Flashpoint, we're always to the right of center. See you tomorrow night.
Join us tomorrow night for Super Tuesday coverage in the Spirit of Faith with Gene Bailey and our panel of experts. 9 p.m. Eastern, 8 p.m. Central.
I am so excited because I have huge expectations for the